the public administrator graduate, but who has chosen to be a Kashu agripreneur. Adama Samuel Fofana. Born and raised in Koinadugu, Northern Province, Sierra Leone, who started doing agricultural activities when she was elected as head girl of Kabbalah Secondary School. According to her, she used to plant cabbage, garden eggs, and lettuce at their school farm, as Kabbalah is known for its vegetable agricultural processes.
An idea we start way back with Abidigo Kabbalah Secondary School. I was a school head girl, and during the time then day we been get school garden where you go to school, the school give you agriculture farm, they work on them, they wanna distribute the crops then at the school. By then Abidigo something like the lettuce, the cabbage, and that of concuba we distribute at the communities and so.
Adama did not read agriculture at the university level, but her passion for agriculture and her vision to solve issues and concern of food insecurity, malnourishment, and to be a social entrepreneur has led her to own one of the fastest growing cashew farms at Yonibana, mile 91, Tonkolili district.
Like me daddy, we actually give back to me, so we been get this idea, we be start on farming, but not me take as anything serious when I did cashew farming. So later on, I will pick up this cashew farming and decide for work on a cashew farm where we will see now. So, Yonibana community inside mile 91, we say we get a cashew farm where they grow up. I get past 150 trees them.
In 2015, when she entered the University of Makini, she was motivated by her dad and friends. Now Adama has gone beyond just a school garden, and now she has gathered a team of 8 people and volunteers with a running stipend.
Me na Mohamed Kamara, a born of mile 91, na da grew up. See now starts for do this program here, all this woman culture to we. And obvious by now, don't begin feel the profit for that. Now they survive the, they get to the each day now and picking them now. Right now, I already pay the school picking them for we. And all the people then, some of them, they be wondering we now, and this will care because of them. We don't see the benefits.
Me na farmer ta konte, I dey work na Swami's cashew farm. I dey Yonibana. Me na the supervisor. For more, I don't graduate. Like this, my friend, we na Adama. Adama come on board, put we together. He explained to me about this cashew farm. So he puts we to this cashew farm. So we all see the benefits of that. And the community, we all pray for let this cashew farm for let extend. So that we say the people around in the way, the people around in the community, then go able, themselves go able benefits through that. So this cashew farm don't help me because for me I don't graduate, I not able get job. But this cashew farm, it don't help me where as for now I dey get what I'm supposed to get for the day.
According to her, she aims to reach the level where she can be a provider and a supplier for cashew in different produce like cashew plumpy nuts, cashew jam, cashew oil, and with an added value to produce cashew in a sealed packet than selling it around town with just plastic, and hope to see one day she produce for supermarkets and eventually do cashew exportation for the internal market.
2 years ago, we been get farmers around the 91. We come buy, like even the kai way they can buy, then go do them, and know can be nice because they can buy the cashew. They way them buy like that small polyplastic and buy 15 or 20,000. Then back they go, then go some, and they, you know, medically, you know, too okay because they go on safe with them that preventive make. Then they only need looking to them. But then I go and burn them from. They get that cashew. They say they sell in 2,000, 5,000. At least if we don't reach that kind of peak where we say we just come do the harvest, we get smashed, we go just fully do the grain, all them things, and they will see other counties and they do them. But the support in all this, and I make come for this platform for sell out people, let them come. And even this cashew they see from research also don't notice say even the cashew itself in water they will get something they call vogard wine form where they be manufactured. These are all things very beautiful from cashew, but they only come into existence when the support day and when people will come for invest and see that we work together and make this big dream be achieved. They see the likes of different business people them where they don't go to and other people where they admire sitting at the world. They start from small way, but because they get people wake up, they invest, and today these are people who they see out there as big investors and as big entrepreneurs. And so they ask that the government, the Ministry of Youth, they champion this event, the Minister of Agriculture, and all other people, and for able to feel like say they come and support see the farm in there, for able to see that we able to reach out there.
It was after her graduation in 2019, she registered Summit Agriculture Farm as a business farm.
Actually, one for people we will come for like see that say we will give an added value and packaging into the cashew things that will the intent for it. Like the inspiration and the motivation from young entrepreneur and business owner. We now, why young somebody we now in our the coordinator also we the serve now the Summit Empire. We now, one young entrepreneur in the name of Mr. Iskandi and Mami Sankowe safe, they give so much to the farm for see that say. Despite the challenges like the fire incidents we happen, no one forgive up. It motivates me. I think I motivation and they are the express to see from other ministries, then we will kind of see that say this small dream it actually end up for be a big thing. We not to just me and my community will be part of for the country at large.